Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the most beautiful names. And when we say beautiful, the top of the line of beauty, the most perfect beauty that you may imagine.
The most beautiful names belong only to Allah, so call on Him with them.
What is more important than knowing who is Allah? The first pillar of Iman is al-Imanu billah. And who is Allah? Our only source of knowledge with regards to Allah is His names and attributes. We have no other way of knowing who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. And that is why our scholars mention that knowledge of Allah is half of Tawheed. And the other half of Tawheed is worshipping Allah. So all of Tawheed revolves around knowing Allah and then worshipping Allah. That's all of Tawheed. La ilaha illallah. You have to know who is Allah and then you worship Allah alone.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has so many names. So many names. Way beyond 120, 140. In fact, we don't know the exact number of names that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has. He has beautiful names. But there are 99 names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you were to memorize 99 of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know them, you memorize them, you understood them, you live by them, you use them to call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, whoever does that, dakhal al-jannah. They will be granted entry into Jannah because they have recognized Allah.
All the names describe Allah. So all the names belong to who? To Allah. Bismillah, in the name of Allah, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. So Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim described who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And realize, my dear brothers and sisters, that a knowledge of Allah's names and attributes is the most noble knowledge. There is nothing that is more sacred, more blessed than a knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
He instructs them to worship Him through His most beautiful names. But in practical terms, what we're talking about here is that the believer dedicates his life to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through his knowledge or her knowledge of the names of Allah, the significance of those names relative to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the effect that those names should have on us as believers.
Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Allahu as-samad. So ahad as-samad describes who? Allah. It's important. It is the name by which all other names become descriptive terms. They are used to describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah has commanded us to learn who He is. There is a command in the Quran, i'lam and i'lamu. This means learn and know. And it occurs around a dozen and a half or two dozen times in the Quran. And in fact, if you look at every single time Allah says i'lam and i'lamu, the majority of them are followed by a name and attribute of Allah. اِعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ اِعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ وَاعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ. Know that Allah, know that Allah, know that Allah. So the primary command to know, اِعْلَمْ, in the Quran is followed by some name or attribute of Allah, because Allah wants us to know who He is. How do we expect to worship Allah if we don't know who Allah is? How will we love Allah if we don't know who Allah is? How will we fear Allah if we don't know who Allah is? How will we put our trust in Allah, our yaqeen, our tawakkul, if we don't have a knowledge of who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is?
Sat and thought about the meanings of these names? Do you know what exactly they entail? If you make a small effort, Allah says, "Inna lillahi ta'ala." This is in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu in Sahih al-Bukhari. He says, Allah has 99 names which if you were to memorize, you would get Jannah. Man ahsaha aw hafidhaha dakhala al-Jannah. Whoever memorizes them and has encompassed them will be granted Jannah. This does not only mean to know them off by heart, but you are living in the nightclubs or you are living in haram. No, You need to know them and try your best to live by them.
And that is why knowledge of Allah is a central tenet of our iman and our tawheed. Our scholars mention that there is no science that causes our iman to increase as much as a knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Iman increases by many ways. Doing any good deed, reading the Quran, giving to the poor, sponsoring an orphan. All of these things increase our iman. But what is the fastest, the quickest way? What is the dosage of iman that will be the maximum? Our scholars say nothing increases iman more than a knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So we can say without any hesitation that what is known as knowledge of Allah's names and attributes, this is the most important area of knowledge. If we are to know Allah and worship Him, then this is where we have to start.
Never, ever, ever, whether pre-Islam or post-Islam, a human being had the guts to call himself Allah. Never. Name himself Allah.
When Allah informed the angels that He was going to create a vicegerent in the earth, a Khalifa, and they questioned the consequence of the creation of man on earth, having observed the consequence of the creation of the jinn, they saw corruption, they saw the spilling of blood, they saw harm coming out of it. So they asked Allah, when you have us worshipping you, why create this other being who is likely to create corruption? So Allah informed them that He knew what they didn't know, and then He taught Adam the names of everything. وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. And of course, the names which Allah began to teach Adam was of course beginning naturally with the names of Allah. Because what are the most important names of anything? Of anything in existence, the most important names must be naturally the names of Allah themselves.
And in fact, if you think about it, brothers and sisters, every single name of Allah will bring about a new knowledge about Allah that we didn't have before. When we learn the meaning of Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, Al-Salam, Al-Mu'min, Al-Muhaymin, Al-Aziz, Al-Jabbar, Al-Mutakabbir, Al-Ra'uf, Al-Rahim, and on, each one of these names will bring about a new experience, a new yaqeen, a new love, a new hope. There is nothing of these names and attributes except that a knowledge of it will increase instantaneously our love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as I said, there is nothing else that increases iman like a knowledge of Allah's names and attributes.
The Lord of the heavens and the earth and what's in between them, worship Him and be patient in worshiping Him. Look at this. هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيَّ. Do you know anyone else called himself Allah? The most beloved words to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَحَبُّ الْكَلِمَاتِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَرْبَعُ فُورُ. لَا يَضُرُّكُ. It doesn't matter with which you begin with. سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ.
Allah reminds us in the Quran in four times this ayah occurs in the Quran. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. Four different times Allah says the same thing. And to Allah belong the most magnificent and the most perfect names. Al-Asma al-Husna. I want you to memorize this phrase. Allah calls His names Al-Asma al-Husna. And Ahsan means, as we all know, we should all know, Ahsan means the most perfect. Hasan means good. Ahsan means the most perfect. Allah's names are not Hasan. Allah's names are not just good. Allah's names are Ahsan, the best. There's nothing more magnificent, more beautiful, more perfect, more majestic than the names of Allah. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. To Allah belong the most perfect, the most majestic, the most beautiful names. So what do we do with those names? فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا. Make dua to Him using those names. And one of the meanings of dua, by the way, isn't just raise your hands up. One of the meanings of dua is to worship. And so, فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا. Worship Him using those names.
The key here is understanding first. Having knowledge. Knowledge is the foundation. We need to understand them. Having understood them, then we need to give them their right. What is the rights of Allah's names? The rights, first and foremost, is that we believe in Allah in accordance with those names. We believe in Allah in accordance with those names, because that will identify for us the correct way to believe in Allah. Allah revealed those names primarily for us to understand who He is, so that we don't mix up His creatures with Him. So we don't give the rights which are due to Him to His creatures, which is what has happened to so many people on the earth today in the various religions and systems that are out there. People have confused Allah with His creation. They've given the rights which belong to Allah, they've given that over to His creatures.
And dear brothers and sisters, realize that our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that there is no being who loves to be praised more than Allah, and that is why he has praised himself. You see, any one of us, when we praise anyone, that praise is half true and half not true, because none of us is perfect. But when Allah is praised, that praise does not even do justice to Allah. You see, when I praise you, there are faults that you have and I don't know about. And that is why we are told not to exaggerate in praising another human being. No human being is worthy of praise unconditionally. Only a conditional praise. You are a kind person sometimes. Nobody can be kind always. You are a gentle person sometimes. But no one can be praised unconditionally other than one being. And that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So the principle here is to understand those names, and then first and foremost, to give Allah His right with regards to those names, to act in accordance with them, to put them into our own lives so that our lives reflect the names of Allah and become lives truly pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With that, dear viewers, we're going to stop here. And I hope to see you in the next segment of our program, In the Names of Allah.